A very good morning to one and all. Children, this is your English language class and we are going to begin a new topic today, which is verbs. Children, as you all already know, verbs are action words in a sentence. Okay, when you say something, verbs are the words which tells us about the action taking place. All right, let us see more about it. An action verb describes what someone or something is doing. All right, it describes, it tells us what someone or something is doing. For example, she tasted the stew. Now tasted is the verb. The bus arrived on time. Here arrived is the action word, so arrived is a verb. All right, children. Then we even saw, children, before, some helping verbs. If you remember, we did is, am, are, was, were, has, have, had, do, does, did. Okay, so now we are going to see some more. See, you can see on your screen right now, all these are helping verbs. Okay, the verbs which are there with the main verbs, and they tell about the action. They tell more about the action. Do, might, must, can, be, could, all these are helping verbs only. We have seen there are 23 helping verbs. Remember that? Very good. Okay, so let us see helping verbs also now. A helping verb works together with the main verb. All right, sometimes, children, we only have helping verb in the sentence, and sometimes helping verb is there with the main verb. All right, but that doesn't matter. Helping verb is also a verb and main verb is also a verb. All right, like she is leaving. Here is the helping verb, leaving is the main verb, but is and leaving both are termed as verbs. All right, I have finished my work. Have is a helping verb and finished is the main verb. Let us see some more. Helping verbs are verbs that come from before the main verb in a sentence. When a main verb is there in a sentence, then helping verbs are there before the main verb. But sometimes there is no main verb and helping verb only acts as the main verb in a sentence. All right? Okay. There are 23, children. Am is are, was and were, being been and be, has, have had, do, does, did, shall, should, will and would. There are 5 more helping verbs: may, might, must, can and could. So children, we will be studying more helping verbs, the ones which we did before. Other than them, some more helping verbs we will be seeing in our next class. All right, right now for this class we have to concentrate on verbs and helping verbs. When in a sentence, if you see a verb and a helping verb both, you are going to underline both. All right. Okay, now children, you have to remember one more thing which is very, very important, that when the subject is singular, when the subject in a sentence is singular, the verb in the sentence will also be singular. All right, subject, if you remember, we have seen subject in a sentence is the person, one who is doing the action. All right, so when the subject is singular, one, the verb will also be singular, one. Okay, so to make a verb singular, we add s to its end. All right, when the subject is plural, there will not be any s in the verb. For example, the dog chases the cat. Okay, the dog chases. You have added s to the word chase. Okay, chase is the verb. The dog chases the cat. Now when the subject is plural, the dogs, it, this verb becomes chase. Okay, there will be no s. So the dogs chase the cat. Okay, so singular subject will have singular verb. In singular verb, s is there. Plural subject will have plural verb. Okay, no s is there. All right, children. Okay, so we will be discussing that more in the class. Now let us see and read from your book. The girl sings sweetly. He spoke very kindly to the girl. The sun rises in the east. They saw the movie last night. Children, in these sentences, sings, spoke, rises, saw, all these are verbs, all right? A verb is mainly a doing word, an action word. It says that someone or something does an action. Such a word is also called an action word, all right? Now, words like be, when be is written, children, under that, am, is, are, was, were. All these helping verbs come under the word be. So, if you see somewhere be, you have to read the sentence and accordingly put the helping verb whichever fits there. Like am or is or are or was or were. That depends upon the sentence. And have. Under have, you have, has and had. These are also included in the verbs. These are helping verbs. They tell us what someone or something is or has. Like she is my friend. Mary had a little lamb. Okay. A verb is not always just one word, okay? It may often consist of more than one word. Like she is writing a letter. Here is a helping verb. Writing is the main verb. So is writing. We are going to take this full thing as the verb, okay? The main verb and the helping verb. They are quarreling with each other. Are is the helping verb. Quarreling is the main verb. So we will take are quarreling. These two words as the verb. A verb is a word used to express an action, state or possession. Now read the following sentences. I play cricket. She plays football. In both the sentences, children, you have seen the subject I. When the subject is I, you have used play as the verb. When the subject is she, singular, the verb will also be singular, and you have to add s to it, like she plays football. Okay, in both these sentences the subject is in the singular number, but in the first sentence the subject I belongs to the first person, in the second sentence the subject she belongs to the third person. We have seen first person, second person and third person in personal pronouns. Remember, children? Very good. So I is a subject, which is an exception. I is a singular subject, but it takes plural verb. All right. Otherwise, singular subject, singular verb, plural subject, plural verb. All right. Always remember, we generally make a singular verb by adding s at the end. Okay. For example, the boy reads a book. Now, reads is a singular verb. As after the word read, you have s. So, reads is a singular verb. And here the subject is singular. They're talking about one boy. So, the boy reads a book. We do not add s in the plural verbs. For example, boys go to school. Now, boys is the subject, plural subject. So, the verb will also be plural, which is go. You will not put any s to it. And I is a special pronoun, okay? It is a singular subject, but it takes plural verb. I is special. Alright. I drink coffee. You did not add any S to it. I is singular. But the plural. The verb here is plural. Alright. We will be discussing more about it in the class. We will practice exercises. And that will make the concept all the more clear, children. Alright. Till then, go through your exercises. Go through the book. Have a nice day. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you.